Begin with the stories making the headlines in Kisumu County, where in Kisumu, a family wants investigations done to ascertain what led to the death of their kin, a nurse, whom they say died under mysterious circumstances. Our team has been digging to get to the bottom of this story, and we're now joined by KETN's Kevin Ogutu for more. Kevin Ogutu, good afternoon. What do we know so far?
Well, Brenda, if you ask me, it is a quite a somber mood right here. I'm at the home of Caroline Mwenesi, the 53-year-old nurse who passed on at the Aga Khan Hospital on Friday, the 31st of July 2021. We've just finished interviewing the family members. We spoke to her daughter, Lavenda Alvista, who was with her at the time of her death. When she went for the MRI scan at the same facility where she was a staff. Apart from that, we've also spoke with the sister, Florence Mwenesi, who had that long-term engagement with her during her stay here in Kisumu, working at that particular facility. Well, up to now, we need to make it very clear that we have not yet reached out to the Aga Khan Hospital for comment on this. But for now, we are going to get it from the horse's mouth, the account, what the family is saying. And I'm here with Florence Mwenesi. Florence Mwenesi, Brenda, is the sister to the late Caroline Mwenesi. You, karibu kwenye KTN News. You probably just told us a lot about the very last moments of your sister Caroline Mwenesi. She was in good health when she left this house for Aga Khan Hospital. Maybe just tell Kenyans what exactly she was going to do and how now she ended up in the morgue in the same facility.
I am Florence Mwenesi. I stay in Kitengela, Nairobi. That is Kajiado County. I landed here in Kisumu on Friday at 7:12. I called my sister Caro. I asked her, my sister, how are you? Are you at home? She told me, no, I'm at Aga Khan Hospital. I've been requested to come and do an MRI. So I told her, okay, if you're not at home, then I'm proceeding to Maragoli. She told me, it's okay, let me finish up my treatment, then I'll update you. So after 1 hour, the daughter, Lavenda, called me. She asked me, auntie, where are you? I told her, I'm still in town. So she told me, please, rush to Aga Khan ICU. You are being requested to be here. So in 10 minutes' time, I was at Aga Khan. When I went to the ICU, my sister Caro was lying just there in her own world. She could not even talk to me. She could not even open her eyes. So I cried and asked her, Caro, what has happened? I've just talked to you just an hour ago. Nurses, can you tell me what has happened to my sister? Doctor, tell me what has happened. I didn't get a correct answer. So I stayed there from morning up to 6 in the morning. I requested the doctors so that I can remain behind as her caretaker, but they told me in the ICU they don't allow caretakers, so I had to go home. I was there with my brothers, my sisters-in-law, her children. So the following day, I was called by the hospital. I was in a funeral somewhere, burying my cousin. I was told, Florence, inform your elder brother that you are urgently needed at Aga Khan Hospital ICU department. So I asked, what's the problem? My question was, is Caro dead? I was told, no. Is she breathing? Yes. Then what's the problem? I was told, the doctor wants to explain to us how they were treating Caro. So I told my brothers, okay, my two brothers, I was there with my sisters-in-law, I was there with my aunt. So I told them, so we had to come to, we were driving to Kisumu. Now reaching at Riat, my sister-in-law called me and told me, Mama Isha, pole, Caro ametuacha.
Okay. Well, I want to take you back a bit because I'm being told that we might run out of time.
Yes.
Tell us the circumstances that led to Caro going for that checkup, and maybe the history that she had with that same facility. I mean, earlier on you told us that she was being compelled to undergo MRI for a surgery to be done.
So I remember there was a day, that was 2018, I had come to visit her. By then she was staying at Godika Estate. I was there. It rained heavily that day. I didn't know my sister had an injury on her back that very, very day, during the day. So the driver dropped her at her place. But unfortunately, she got another injury. When she was now alighting from the car, I think there was, I don't know what happened, but she came to the house limping, telling us that when I was working, I got an injury, my back has a problem now, the hip joint. Yeah, I'm having a problem. So the following day, she went for the treatment and she came back. So since that time, she has been complaining, coming to the house. When I'm here, she comes to the house crying. When you ask her, sometimes she cannot talk. Sometimes she can't even eat. She has been complaining that she has been, the CEO has been threatening her because she's getting a full salary and she's not working.
Okay.
Yeah.
Brenda, I'm being told that we have run out of the time that was allocated to us. But what has come out from the family is that they want an explanation that they've not got yet from the Aga Khan Hospital management with regard to the circumstances rather that led to this MRI, that are made to understand that the late Caroline Mwenesi was supposed to, she had told the medics there that she was diabetic, and of course given her weight or BMI, she felt that it was not right to do that. But this is something that of course we are following up. As I mentioned earlier on, we have not yet reached out to the Aga Khan Hospital. This is something that we have to do so that we can have a more comprehensive story in our subsequent bulletins. Back to you in studio, Brenda.
Kevin Ogutu, thank you so much for talking to the family of the late Caroline. You know, we just pray that the questions they have, they'll get the answers soon. A sad incident right there. Away from Kisumu County and